You guys, that's the greatest place on earth. We missed our opportunity to go today. We'll never get over it. Well, we'll get over it whenever we go back to Trader Joe's. But... there's so many things that I tell myself I'm gonna do. And it's very rare that I will do any of them. But, you can only hope that you get better about that over time. You know, that you might not do, like, all 20 things that are on the list, but hopefully you'll do, like, maybe one and a half. So, you guys, I don't think I want to play piano on stage anymore. I say that, and then I bring the keyboard back up there. But I think that I kind of have to be in the right environment to do the piano punk thing. I'm just extremely, weirded out by being on stage. I think it's because, like, when I'm alone, I thrive because there aren't people watching me, and it's like, I think the whole thing with mental illness is, like, you know, awareness of yourself, and I think that the people that don't see themselves at all, people that don't have any idea, like, what they do on a regular basis, they just get mad when things don't go their way. But they don't seem to understand that they have a part in every situation, you know? It's like those people don't have any awareness of how their actions contribute. But they can't see other people if they can't see themselves. But there's just a lot. I know that I always bitch about technology, and then I brag about my flip phone life, as I call it. But it's really not for the purpose of stroking my ego once more. I just really, I really hate how, you know, anything keeps us from ourselves. You know, something comes between us and, you know, our spiritual growth, however you want to label that. And it sucks that people are so open to that, like, they're so open to distractions and those barriers that don't allow them to move forward. And, you know, I see that with drugs and alcohol. I see that with just ways of thinking about things and just staying in the same mindset. And, you know, I don't want to be a negative person about the way that this world is. You know, people have always given in to, what the fuck? They just flashed at me. Does that mean you're not going fast enough? They're, like, way back there. They're, like, super far away. Look. Do you see them? Vortex. See how far away they are? I think sometimes, like, when your car goes over a bump, it does that. Is that true, Vortex? Let me know in the comments. If you go over a bump, do your lights do a little thing where it looks like they're flashing at you, but they don't mean to? Well, see, I can understand if they flash their lights at me if they were, like, on my ass, but they're not on my ass. That's why it doesn't make sense. Maybe they just did it for fun, or maybe they're drunk or something. I don't know. Yeah, so my mom warned me about coming out to Nashville because of, like, the Taylor Swift concerts. But, like, that's on the other side of Nashville. There was, like, no traffic whatsoever in West Nashville because everybody's over in, like, the downtown area. But, yeah, anyway. Yeah, my original subject matter when starting to do YouTube was mental illness. So, that's why I bring up the technology a lot. I really kind of hate that I'm like that. I needed somebody else to say something, though. Because I've always noticed that I do bring that up all the time. And I don't like it. But I also don't like everybody staring at their phone all the time. So, I feel like of all things to gloat about, that's the one. But, well, I like the way that you talk about, like, being a virgin in a way. Because, like, you don't have a hymen anymore, so, like, at least you don't have a Twitter handle or whatever. Yeah. I'm not worried about an algorithm. I'm not worried about pleasing bots, right? That's so weird. Like, of course women are fake, because that's what they seek to please, you know? And these comedians aren't funny because that's also what they seek to please. So it doesn't make any sense. Like, it's just ruining everything. See, here's the thing. There are not enough things I could say about technology and how it ruins shit. So I guess, yeah, I am focused on it. I just need to redirect it rather than just focus on, like, oh, I don't have a smartphone. It's like, yeah, we get it, Amy. We get it. But first of all, I think I need to talk about the solution a lot more. The solution, which is God. But I also need to talk about, you know, different aspects of the culture that I find really problematic, not just, like, the smartphones itself. Well, if you talk about the psychological element of all this stuff, I feel like that's more interesting. Because I feel like that element is more important and it's easier to get away with. You know, because when people talk about politics or they talk about certain issues with gender and race and things like that, they're always coming at it from a very either, like, political angle or religious angle. And, you know, people just don't want to listen to that. So it's like you have to say it in a way that they're not used to hearing that subject talked about. Mm-hmm. So. Sorry, we're brainstorming, y'all. Can you hear it? Can you hear that storm? Can you hear the thunder and the lightning? The lightning's beautiful. I'm so sleepy. I forced myself to come out here. I fucking hate stand-up comedy so much. But I think I did well tonight. Last night, I was not comfortable at all. That's because I had the piano again. I told myself not to bring it up there, but I did it anyway. So, just an instinct thing. Now my instinct is telling me not to do that, so gotta follow the instinct. That was a lesson learned.